Check out this Rhode Show Rewind.
Time for another Michaela and Mommy segment. Childbirth, as we know, can definitely be nerve-wracking, which is why we're helping you prepare. And here with some advice is Deborah White. She's a midwife at South County Health. Welcome.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
First of all, for those who are unfamiliar, could you tell us a little bit about your role, like what a midwife does, if we've never had one in the past?
Sure. Midwives are experts at normal OBGYN. Mm-hmm. We're trained to help women through birth, actually be the baby catcher, attend the births, and see the woman through the whole childbearing year and her whole lifespan.
Mm-hmm. And you can provide a lot of helpful advice, which is what you're going to do for us today.
Okay.
First of all, this is not only before labor, but during labor. So both before you go to the hospital and while you're at the hospital,
sure.
There are some things that moms can do,
absolutely,
and even dads listen up to.
Absolutely.
Ease your nerves a little bit,
sure,
because it can be a very stressful, overwhelming process, especially if you've never been through this before.
Absolutely. You know, as a first-time mom, we all have that anxiety of what can I anticipate? What is this going to look like for me?
Yeah.
When you're home, the biggest thing is positioning. You want to get that baby's back up front so that you don't have back labor. You know, when that baby is laying against your back and mm-hmm. looking at the sky, you're going to have more back pain. So during that early labor, things like the shower, leaning against the back of the shower,
mm-hmm.
Counter pressure on hips, back massage, lightly eating and drinking, and getting on all fours to relieve that back pain.
Really?
There's also a thing called sifting, where you actually cradle the baby and rock,
mm-hmm.
So that back will shift to the front, and it feels so much better if it's aligned well.
Yeah,
and it's faster.
And that back pain can be extremely aggravating,
yes,
at any time of the day. So just a few helpful tactics,
yes,
throughout it, whether it's that nice warm water in the
mm-hmm.
shower, and you take advantage of stretch.
You can absolutely do that even when you get to the hospital.
Okay.
You know, the South County has showers in each of the rooms.
Mm-hmm.
Some people prefer after they get there, we have a large tub for both the partners and
yeah,
the mama to be.
We did show that in one of our segments.
And it's big.
Very relaxing. And
very.
The temperature is not overwhelming too, because I know a lot of moms are thinking, well, I can't
go in a
hot tub. You
have to keep it at 99,
mm-hmm,
because you don't want to heat up mom. Mom's
right.
already warm.
Yeah.
And she's working, so there's no reason to.
Mm-hmm.
And so you have the waterfall, the low lights, and that helps with being distracted from the discomfort.
Very soothing. Speaking of discomfort, contractions are going to happen.
They're going to happen.
How can we cope with those?
So again, the water therapy does help. Some people will opt for nitrous. Nitrous
mm-hmm.
is part nitrogen, 50%, and part oxygen.
Okay.
South County has introduced that into as a tool
mm-hmm.
for pain.
As opposed to an epidural?
They try that first.
Oh,
some
okay.
people will like that because they can still be up moving, they're still engaging in the whole process, and it gives pain relief at the peak of the contraction. The blessing is it does not cross the placenta. So moms often say, oh, is this going to hurt my baby? How is this going to affect?
Mm-hmm.
And since it doesn't cross the placental barrier, and it's out of her system in like three breaths.
Oh, okay.
Then she can use it and feel free to use it as much or as little as she wants.
Mm-hmm.
So it's self-administered and that helps.
And like you said, that might be the first step. Next might be an epidural, which
then
is
she
a
can
lot
decide,
of people.
Yes, and again, that's a self-select group. They decide at what point. There is no wrong point. I tell people mm-hmm. ask, well, when is it too late? I say, when we see the baby's head, it's too late.
Yeah, at that point,
when we see the baby's
they're
head,
coming whether you want
right,
it.
Right, then we'll talk about something else. We'll pull
yeah.
the nitrous out again even for that.
Mm-hmm. And another option to even IV sedation.
We do, but most people okay. are not choosing that as much.
Okay.
Now that we have the nitrous,
mm-hmm.
because they don't want to feel sleepy.
Yeah,
they're
they want to feel alert. They want to make
right.
sure they're remembering
so
that moment.
We use it for that what's called prodromal labor, where it's the start of labor, but we can't seem to kick it over. They're
mm-hmm.
exhausted from starting their process, but
yeah.
or the anxiety is a little high.
Well, like you said, because mom needs a lot of energy
mm-hmm.
as that's happening, and sometimes you're laboring for days.
Right.
You
that
hear.
Is a normal process. Anywhere from 12 to 24 hours first time is perfectly normal.
Mm-hmm. Which is why someone like you, though, you could offer some advice. Do you want some relief
sure.
right now? You'll still be alert
again
in a few hours.
It's the position changes. We do
mm-hmm.
a lot of position changes in labor.
Okay.
The beds can do amazing tricks. We're on the ball. We're
mm-hmm.
we're sifting. We're doing counter pressure. And massage, it's great.
Yeah, whatever helps get
whatever
everyone
gets,
out and everyone safe
yes,
and healthy.
Yes.
Deb, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
If you want to review these tips, go to roadshow.com.
Thank you for having me.
Be sure to catch The Road Show, weekday mornings at 9 on WPRI 12.